Here comes the party!
Hi guys, it's Carolina Rabassa. I'm a voice actress from Colombia. I've been fortunate to lend my voice to iconic characters in major gaming franchises, particularly proud of representing Latin American characters. And today is all about that, giving a voice to Latin America's presence in the gaming industry by highlighting some of its finest. But before we delve into the showcase, let's celebrate some games available to play right now. Starting with the game that made this segment possible, a charismatic story-driven roguelike deck builder featuring Foam Gun, Enter Planet Ship, Baby Violence. Let's kick things off with Zetzillions. Apagando las luces!
Boop. Hey everyone, Ayrton here, the producer from Otaimon Studios. We just released our latest game, Zetzillions, in partnership with Rob Fury, and we are so happy to be here showcasing it at the Latin America Games Showcase. Adding our voice to these other amazing developers is such an honor for us, and we really hope our community is having fun with Zetzillions. We're still hard at work, getting ready to bring some new content to the game, so keep your eyes peeled. Thanks a lot for the support, and now, enjoy the show.
Commander, we got volunteers!
Frigajam!
Meatballs!
Maybe we got a chance!
I can sense Thanatos Bloodhound's aura behind us!
I win, you win!
If we want to stand a chance and fight, we gotta keep moving!
Time for some fireworks, Commander!
Fire! Welcome aboard, Kami!
In a forgotten age, the ancients mastered secrets we cannot fathom. Today, their presence has vanished, their legacy buried beneath a world engulfed in darkness. Only Aster, the young chosen one, possesses the power to defy his evil and restore their last glory. Venture towards the monolith, a beacon of immense power left by the ancients. Face and conquer the dark forces that threaten to devour the world. Can Aster unravel the secrets of the ancients and save his people? Will Aster become the blade of the monolith?
Morning, boy.
Hey, Lily! Ready to set sail?
Absolutely, Howard. I can't wait to find the last disc. Howard?
this game blows your mind. Mullet Mad Jack.
There have been reports of a rogue esper of sorts. His name is Golden Butterfly, and he is not to be trusted.
Is he dangerous?
I now have access to every file in the Minerva database, which is a pretty stellar move, if you ask me.
What is the real reason behind this? To feel good about yourself?
This is exciting, Luna.
Oh. So that's it. Maybe we'll see each other again.
My crew and I are taking the system down and the city back. It's time to finish this masterpiece. Afraid you're gonna have to try harder than that. It's not your city, dammit. Rakugaki. Available now.
Welcome to the Summer Game Fest edition of the Latin American Games Showcase. Brace yourselves for a selection of over 70 titles from across Latin America, each a statement to the talent and dedication of our developers. Expect world premieres, exciting game announcements, and exclusive glimpses into upcoming releases. Keep an eye out for this logo, signaling which games have playable demos. We're actually having a Steam sale event running from today until June 15th, featuring over 150 games, including a rich assortment of demos and discounts. None of this would be possible without the long-lasting support of our presenting sponsors, Devolver Digital, Raw Fury, and Fellow Traveler, and to our sponsor, Panic. And now let's dive in, beginning with a selection of games bound to captivate you with their unique gameplay mechanics.
World Premiere.
We'll be right back. monster slaughtered my entire world.
Embark on an electrifying journey in Into the Grid, a thrilling roguelike deck builder that pushes the boundaries of a strategic gameplay. Dive into a cyberpunk setting where every move could be your last, and skillful hacking is the key to unleashing your power. In Into the Grid, players will explore labyrinthian grid-based maps, where every node is full of risks and rewards. Discover powerful card synergies, unlock special abilities, and unravel the mysteries of a vibrant universe as you make your way through the digital maze. Augment your arsenal with upgraded cards and experiment with formidable combinations to crush your enemies. Master the groundbreaking Vim Dual Resource System, which rewards expertise with unparalleled control and bring the evil corporations to their knees. Into the Grid presents 5 different characters, each with its own story arc, mechanics, and challenges. Prepare to dive again and again into the next level of narrative world building, uncovering new depths with every playthrough. Jack in and prepare to be absorbed as you venture into the grid. We'll be right back.
And so it came to pass that all of humanity was punished for the sins of a single man. Now is time for those that remain to claw back our home and weather the tides of damnation. And you, our Lord, must forge our fate.
Please, Iron Lord, our people are starving.
Flesh will fade, strength of steel endures.
Rise, brothers, your hive calls. A sacrifice must be made.
Stand strong. Steel your heart. The Iron Hive endures.
El Diablo me parece un personaje latinoamericano que se repite en muchísimas historias, que está constantemente en varios de nuestros espacios, en nuestras narrativas. Me encanta el Diablo.
Voy a decir una cosa extraña, pero Gabriel García Márquez, yo creo que nos hace falta hacer algunas cosas de realismo mágico más. Creo que el formato del realismo mágico se podría representar muy bien en un videojuego. De hecho, se ha hecho en otros juegos, pero creo que de su obra podría salir algo muy interesante.
Don Francisco, we need to put him in a game running some form of very scary show that becomes like more and more sinister. Is he still alive? I don't think he is. I think he passed away. Can somebody confirm that for me? I don't know what's it.
To your wish list, coming soon.
Round one, go!
Arco is a tactical turn-based action RPG that invites you to saddle up and ride alongside several characters on a quest for vengeance in an untamed frontier of pixelated vistas. Today, we'll deep dive into some of its mechanics with never-before-seen footage of a boss fight that'll make even the most hardened monster hunter sit up and take notice. This is an advanced section of the game where we follow two cunning twag siblings that are knee-deep in an epic heist. In Arco, all of your decisions matter, and whatever you choose will have an impact in the story, your progression, and combat. Want to test dynamite and rouse the chupacabra from its slumber? Well, that's your call. Combat is also riddled with decisions. Will you move away from an impending attack or position yourself in the best place for a big blow? With character-driven abilities like a slick teleport or a well-timed boom, you'll be dancing circles around your foes. But mind your magia points, partner. You don't want to find yourself in a tighter spot. Strategize with your moves, manage your abilities, and knock that goal clean off that chupacabra. Don't just take my word for it though. Add Arco to your wish list and try out the demo. It's time to taste the dust and grit of Arco's world for yourself.
E aí o carnaval tem muitas cores, muita música, muitas roupas elegantes e divertidas. Então, um jogo que conseguisse misturar a mecânica de design de roupas com até mesmo gerenciar um desfile, eu acho que seria algo muito divertido.
Há algo que existe em Colômbia, que é o tejo. O objetivo deste jogo é lançar um pedaço de metal a um aro e o papel lleno de pólvora explode. Então, creio que algo com isso estaria muito interessante de fazer.
O transporte público, porque é bastante caótico e tienes que estar como que muito atento, y creo que es una experiencia como de survival y ver como que a qué micro le entras. Es más, creo que hay un juego peruano que se inspiró bastante en eso para hacer un juego.
Creo que podríamos hacer algo con el Día de Muertos y con el cempasúchil y con esta idea de que nos vienen a visitar cada año y la comida va perdiendo el sabor, y creo que eso también estaría muy padre para un videojuego.
En la entretejida línea del tiempo, acá en esta tierra ya habitada, llegaron ellos. Los primeros se decían ser. Acá en la llanura donde cubrimos hoy con nuestro cuerpo el manto gris de esta ciudad desolada. Ellos, los anhelantes viajeros del mar, nacidos del continente de los reyes, sin saber qué les deparaba, de trabajo, sudor y lágrimas, armaron sus casas de barro y plantaron vida, compartiendo con otros cuya naturaleza desconocían.
No es un quinoma, la vimos. ¿Para qué quieres entrar?
Y con más fuerza que nunca lucharon para mantener sus raíces, sus creencias.
Algo distinto que vive en lo profundo. Es como una sombra. Ahora lo siento conmigo todo el tiempo.
Be me. What are you doing here?
The world's
1921, Un sueño profundo es un docu-videojuego narrativo que sigue la vida del fotoperiodista Juan Aguirre. Él se verá involucrado en uno de los misterios políticos más importantes en la historia de México, el asesinato del presidente electo Álvaro Obregón. Este demo comienza en el año de 1921, 7 años antes del magnicidio. En este nivel, el tercero en el orden del juego, se desarrolla en la Plaza de la Constitución, donde se celebran las fiestas del centenario de la independencia. Como periodista, Juan cuenta con una serie de habilidades y mecánicas que le ayudarán a ir cumpliendo distintas misiones en cada nivel. La mecánica principal de Juan es su cámara. Esta mecánica fue desarrollada teniendo en mente las dificultades y los retos de la fotografía análoga de la época. Y por otro lado, Juan puede recolectar objetos históricos coleccionables. Algunos pertenecen a colaboraciones que tiene Mácula con institutos como la Hemeroteca Nacional de la UNAM o el Museo de Arte Popular. También, como parte de su labor periodística, Juan entrevista a distintos personajes en el nivel para ir descifrando el misterio que lo envuelve. En algunas ocasiones, Juan se encontrará con personajes históricos que lo harán contextualizarse más en esta época. Juan tiene una libreta que funciona como un hub del juego. En ella podrás encontrar las diferentes misiones, las fotografías que has tomado, los objetos con los que has interactuado y los personajes históricos que has conocido. Y por último, Juan cuenta con su modo metiche. Esta función te ayudará a escuchar conversaciones secretas y encontrar objetos que te ayudarán a avanzar en las misiones. A través de la historia de Juan, podrás explorar espacios reales de la Ciudad de México, como el Zócalo de la Ciudad, el Exconvento de la Merced, e incluso entrar a Palacio Nacional para adentrarte en el México postrevolucionario.
El otro día estábamos hablando de Luis Miguel, que justo estaría súper interesante de así, de el sol de México. O sea, así como latinoamericanos, yo creo que es una de las personas como más icónicas que yo sé que han existido y trascendido los países dentro de Latinoamérica.
Selena, Dios mío, Selena merece un videojuego. ¿Y qué tipo de videojuego? ¿Qué tal uno de ritmo?
No.
no sé, Chayanne. Creo que Chayanne es un buen ejemplo. Es como uno de los cantantes que une generaciones y a, sobre todo a las mamás y a los hijos. Creo que Chayanne sería un buen ejemplo ahí para colocar de Latinoamérica. World Premiere.
Ya se mira el horizonte, combatiente zapatista. El camino marcará a los que vienen atrás. Vamos, vamos, vamos adelante, para que salgamos de la lucha avante. Porque nuestra patria grita y necesita de todo el esfuerzo de los zapatistas.
As we reach the midpoint, let me take a moment to thank our presenting sponsors, Fellow Traveler, an indie games label dedicated to storytelling in games. Check their upcoming titles, Wonder Stars and Culebra and the Souls of Limbo. Raw Fury, a publisher with a long-standing commitment to supporting developers in Latin America, showcased by our opening title, Set Zillions. And Devolver Digital, renowned for supporting and promoting the artistic visions of developers around the world, as exemplified by Neva, an emotionally charged action-adventure game that shines with its breathtaking watercolor landscapes and touching soundtrack. So who better than them to present our next segment?
List now on Steam.
They used to say that Midnight Cove was the city that never wakes up. Just another boring shithole of a town forgotten by God's touch.
Come on, show me what you've got.
I'll take a look at it. This place has become a blooming dumping ground.
I've heard that someone's been asking about you down at the Rusty Crow.
Here, to both of you. I promise they will pay.
He was taken away. There is a horrible stench and black goo everywhere.
Ah! play the demo now on Steam. Soon available on your favorite platforms.
Despelote is a slice-of-life adventure about childhood and the magical grip that soccer held over the people of Ecuador in 2001. By then, Julián Cordero, part of this small depth team from Ecuador, was at the perfect age to embrace not just the sport, but also the freedom and magic he felt just by kicking the ball around. With the ball at our feet, the world transforms into a playground for mischievous adventures, wonderful exploration, and unforgettable human connections. All kinds of connections. But time is not on your side. Taking away precious recess moments and park visits, would you seize every opportunity for fun? Or be left watching wistfully from the edge of the window? Despelote will soon put the ball at your feet. But for now, catch these content creators playing an exclusive demo on their channels starting on June 10th. Despelote, a game by Julián Cordero and Sebastián Balbuena.
Welcome to Ultimate Tower! Ultimate Robot Paradise!
Yeah, right! Alright, everybody, this takes a reset. Next time driving, use full throttle.
Without a loyal crew, and I'm searching for the best. Okay, team, let's focus. Watch your back, Mio! The Alliance isn't letting up. We need to get stronger. It's going to be tough, but I can't do it without you guys.
ある全ての惑星の崩壊を引き起こしている。全ての命の崩壊。危険、狂気、最後の決戦の時が来た。 アドベンチャーゲームで未来を救うことができるのは勇敢な選手のグループだけだ。インディーゲームアクションの力。
る。光、そして肉体。忍者ガレージプレゼンツ、ザ・キャベッジエフェクト、価値ある冒険、近日公開。
Existe el concepto de las maquinitas, que son este lugar que eran los arcades. Era un lugar que no le gustaba a los papás en los 90s porque decían, están de vagos nada más, etc. Y sí atraía a un cierto tipo de población. Pero recuerdo que había una señora en mi pueblo que se llamaba Pasita. Y recuerdo que cuando llovía apagaba las maquinitas a fuerzas porque decía que una vez alguien en la Ciudad de México le había caído un rayo y le había explotado la máquina y nos quería cuidar de eso.
We had moved from the Dominican Republic to the United States. And we never went out. And so for us, video games was the way that we would interact with each other and also have friends over. And so my mother was the one who introduced me to video games.
Muchísimas memorias hermosas. Me acuerdo en realidad, ahora que me haces acordar, es de ir a la feria y comprar los cartuchos de Family, el adaptador, y poder jugar un montón de otras versiones de juegos hackeados. Y me acuerdo en particular uno que era un hack de Chip and Dale, que estaba también Mario y Sonic como personajes elegibles. Y la verdad que tipo, me quedó esa memoria grabada y era muy divertido. World Premiere.
Thank you.
En Chile tenemos muchas leyendas urbanas o mitos, por así decirlo, y creo que el Caleuche es un barco fantasma muy icónico, entonces creo que deberíamos aprovechar eso. Y no he visto Caleuche en videojuegos, lo he visto en cómics, películas, pero no en videojuegos.
Una que me encanta creo que es el Chupacabras. El Chupacabras es este animal ahí mitológico, lleno, rodeado de leyendas, tanto políticas como sociales en México, que creo que haría una buena historia.
No sé si es ni siquiera argentina, tal vez es mendocina, que es de donde soy yo, de Mendoza, que es el futre, una persona sin cabeza del campo. El campo mendocino, tipo desierto, que anda ahí, te agarra el futre y te hace mierda, así que hay que correr del futre.
realm weighs heavy. It took so much from me. But not even that thing is going to keep me from claiming what's mine.
Concludes our showcase for today. We hope you're already diving into our Steam sale, exploring demos, snagging discounts, and updating your wish lists with all the incredible games you've seen. A massive thank you to our presenting sponsors, Devolver Digital, Rough Fury, and Fellow Traveler. We're also very grateful to Panic, along with our broadcast partners, IGN and Steam. And let's not forget our invaluable allies and partners, River, Adva, Arcela Sound, Pressover, Philo Animation Studios, Cafe Cultivar, and Mion Naroshi. A huge thanks to Jeff Keighley, Emily Bushok, and the entire Summer Game Fest team. Their dedication has been instrumental in amplifying our voices and showcasing our talent to the world. Before we wrap up, here's a message to the scouts and publishers tuning in. Over half of the games showcased today are either self-published or open for publishing opportunities. So if any of these games caught your eye, but you're unsure of how to contact them, reach out. We can help you connect. Stay connected with us on social media and join us throughout the week for developer interviews and exclusive demos. I'm Steffi Varela. It's been an absolute pleasure hosting for you today, but of course, we have one more thing. And trust me, it's going to blow your sombrero right off. Hasta la próxima.
World premiere.
Santa Mascota. El pueblo donde no pasa nada. Hasta ahora.
¡Ah!
entonces aquí está tu servidor, limpiando el cochinero.